Mickey, you still here? Should I make you a drink? Or are you working tonight? Balancing the scales for my many sins.
No. Nothing I do will ever change what happened to Morgan.
I don't know why you said that. I didn't mean to say that. I shouldn't have said it. It's about to talk. I'm real proud. I think it's very noble that you spend your time helping others.
Does that include you?
Oh, sweetie. I think I'm beyond your capabilities.
Good thing I called in reinforcements, then.
Thank you so much for coming. I really appreciate it.
Yeah. Dr. Monroe, you have no business here.
Kiki asked me to come.
She didn't have any right.
She has every right. Ava, she's your daughter. She loves you, and she only wants you to get help.
By ambushing me with you and your servants, Father?
I force you to confront your situation head on. I realize that you're overwhelmed by everything that happened, but you can't keep yourself locked away.
It's my alternative. I'll trot myself off to Dr. Maddox's group therapy session. If I'm going to open myself up to a bunch of strangers, there better be an open bar involved.
That's not usually how therapy works, Ava. Look, I just want to make sure you have the support and security that you need.
Don't worry about that. Because I have my brother. And Julian was good enough to file an insurance claim on the gallery. And thanks to the settlement, I will never have to leave my house again. I can spend the rest of my life behind that closed door, which, believe me, is what's best for everybody.
How often have you practiced that speech? It's good. It's great. I almost bought it. Not quite. The only reason you are hiding out here is because you're afraid.
Of course I'm afraid. You'd be afraid too if you look like this. Do you want to walk down the street every day, knowing that everybody who sees you is just going to stare? You want to see little kids hide behind their mothers? Well, worst of all, they're really good people. Because they go out of their way to smile at you. And really all you know is that they feel pity.
Mom, please stop.
Yeah, I wish I could stop, but I can't. It's the truth. Dr. Monroe, I'm really sorry. But there just isn't any soul here to save.
But you think you can convince me that you have no soul?
I don't need to convince you. I know it's true.
You remember our conversation that night at the floating rib, the night you brought me a drink?
Yeah. Yeah, I do. I was just beginning to feel more hopeful about the future. It's a lifetime ago.
You asked me if there was a sin that couldn't be forgiven. Well, there is one. Despair. And once you give in to despair, you deny all the good things God has ever given you. All the hope, all the forgiveness, all the love. You think you're protecting yourself, but you're condemning yourself to your own personal hell. What's worse, a few strangers turn their back on you on the street? Or you turn your back on God and all creation.